Let's say these are like theory, but if you want to create your first Spring Boot project, so all you have to do is go to start.spring.io. Let's see, go start.spring.io. Go to this website, and this is a very, very good website created by Spring community so that you can have an initial project setup. You can do very easily. Okay, and here you can see it can be a Maven project or a Gradle project. I'll be using Maven project, and there's multiple language options also there. I'll be using Java in this case. Okay, the version is there, so 2.5.6 is very stable, so I'll be using that. So when you create a project, there are certain things that you need to decide, that the group name, artifact name. This way I'll explain when we reach to the Maven point. And you, this artifact is actually a name of the project. Let's say you say your first Spring Boot application. Okay, so you can write it down as for Spring Boot application. I'll be using Java 11, but you can also use Java 8. So these are the default setting. And also to create any web application, we can use dependency. I'll explain about what the dependency is, but let's say I'll add dependency like web. I'll add web here. Okay, I can add more dependency as Swagger. I can add actuator. Okay, so actuator, I'll also explain that what is actuator. So all you have to do is you have to click on generate, and your project will be downloaded with the initial configuration for Spring Boot. Okay, you can copy this project. Into your workspace where your ID is pointed. Okay. And you can double click on that. Your project, your initial project will be ready. So this is your initial project. Now you can point your IDE, Eclipse or IntelliJ to open this application on your Eclipse or IntelliJ. I'll be using IntelliJ. So all you have to do is you have to open this project from this screen. Go to the path where this application is. And you have to point it for Spring Boot application. Okay, you can open this, and I'll use the new window. It will take around 1 or 2 minutes to load the initial project. It will be resolving all the dependencies. Okay, it's downloading all the plugins and all the like dependency that is required by initial Spring Boot application. So after your initial project setup is done, you can open this project and see the structure of the application. Okay, so these are the initial structure that comes when you download project from start.spring.io. You can see there are two important things to consider here. One is like you already have a main application. Okay, with the Spring Boot application annotation here, and you have a pom.xml.